pleasure to be here today for the signing ceremony for the Economic and Social Development Program in St. Kitts and Nevis. I'm aware of the growing sense of urgency that countries in the Caribbean, including St. Kitts and Nevis, have toward addressing their vulnerabilities to natural disasters and climate change. Through this program, Japan will provide St. Kitts and Nevis with Japanese disaster reduction equipment valued at approximately $800,000. This grant aid program is aimed to enhance the disaster preparedness in St. Kitts and Nevis, and it is our hope that this grant aid program will significantly reduce disaster damages in the future. I would also like to call your attention to the first Japan CARICOM Summit meeting held in Port of Spain in July last year. The summit meeting, attended by the Right Honorable Dr. Denzel Douglas, the then Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, and His Excellency Shinzo Abe, Prime Minister of Japan, marked a new chapter for the relations between Japan and CARICOM countries. In line with Japan's policy pillars announced by Prime Minister Abe at the summit meeting, Japan started extending support to CARICOM countries in the area of disaster risk reduction. The provision of Japanese disaster reduction equipment to St. Kitts and Nevis is a clear indication of this policy. I believe that this grant aid program will further enhance cordial relations between Japan and St. Kitts and Nevis and deepen mutual understanding and friendship between the two nations.
His Excellency Mitsuhiko Okada, Ambassador of Japan to St. Kitts and Nevis, Ms. Kay Bass, our Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Aviation, Mr. Osman Petty, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of National Security, Mr. Carl Herbert, National Disaster Coordinator, Mr. Jacob Gumba, Senior Communications Officer of the Nevis Disaster Management Department, and of course, my good friend, Mr. Takafumi Ura, Second Secretary. Members of the media, other invited guests, good morning. Your Excellency, first allow me to use this opportune occasion to applaud the government of Japan on the emphasis it has placed on cementing the long-standing bond of friendship between our two countries. I certainly would like to register our profound gratitude to your government for its unwavering support and the extensive cooperation between our two countries since we established diplomatic relations in 1985. I would especially like to commend you, Your Excellency, for your efforts in ensuring that this project is realized before the end of this year. Given your recent appointment and visit to St. Kitts and Nevis in September of this year, this, to my mind, Your Excellency, signifies your commitment to solidifying our relations. The provision of disaster reduction equipment is a timely and welcome contribution to the National Disaster Management Agency of St. Kitts and Nevis. It is a significant contribution to our efforts to achieve and maintain an appropriate state of national preparedness for natural disasters and other emergencies. This equipment will enhance both the quality, efficiency, and effectiveness of the disaster risk management services in our Federation. Here in St. Kitts and Nevis, we are all familiar with the devastating impact of natural disasters, particularly hurricanes and floods. These disasters have had a debilitating effect on our nation, affecting the root of our economy, tourism and agriculture, and ultimately the livelihood of our people. Furthermore, in the face of climate change and the frequency and severity of natural disasters, our region is particularly vulnerable to these catastrophic events. Thankfully, we have just come to the close of an average 2015 hurricane season, and St. Kitts and Nevis was not severely affected. However, as we reflect on our friends in the Windward Islands, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and St. Lucia, and the nightmare that they endured just before Christmas 2 years ago during the passage of a low-level trough, and as we reflect further on our friends in Dominica and the nightmare that they just endured with the passing of Tropical Storm Erica, we are mindful that we must always be on our guard and always be prepared. It is for this reason that our government is ensuring that a clear plan of action and response strategy is developed so as to mitigate the impact of both natural and man-made disasters. Your Excellency, the government of Japan recognizes our vulnerability and the challenges we face in confronting this present-day reality, as Japan, too, has had its fair share of tsunamis and other natural hazards. So today, you are in solidarity with St. Kitts and Nevis and presenting us this donation. Your Excellency, on behalf of the Prime Minister, the government and people of St. Kitts and Nevis, I extend our sincere appreciation to the government of Japan for the provision of disaster reduction equipment to our Federation. Thank you.